In the sanctum of the Holy Baptism, our Heavenly Father sets his people free from the power of sin and death by uniting us to the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn the children of God and inheritors of the kingdom of heaven. All who are baptized into Christ are members of the Church, the body of Christ, where we grow in grace, a daily increase in faith, love, and obedience to the will of God.
Two young people, Aaron and Thomas, long-standing members of this congregation, will in a few moments be baptized. Along with the threefold pouring of the water, the priest will address them by their names. Not, as bureaucracy forces us to say in this secular age, their first name, or their forename, or their given name, but from that moment, their Christian name. Peter's new name was conferred at Caesarea Philippi, yet in the mind of God it was his from the foundation of the world. God's name, someone says George MacDonald, is God's own idea of that being whom he had in his thought when he began to make the child.
Those beautiful ancient words sung in Aramaic, celebrating the baptism of Jesus. So we give thanks this day for the baptism of these two young men.